Let's continue with the last enhancements concerning horizon management. So those enhancements cover a multitude of aspects and steps of analysis of horizons, including the data conditioning, the domain conversion, the attribute computation, the distance measure tool, the creation of structural maps, the customization of the contouring, and the GRB computation. So one of the kind of conditioning we can perform towards the data mapping is now volume despiking. So for instance, starting from such a seismic data that seems very saturated because of extreme values that can be, of course, QC'd thanks to the color bar and the histogram provided by Paloscan. Now, thanks to the despiking tool, we can apply a cutoff concerning the values by removing the voxel values above a maximum amplitude and below a minimum amplitude in order to recover an acceptable histogram towards a proper display of the data and, of course, towards a proper analysis of attributes and the proper conditioning for instance, the propagation of horizons. Other improvements concerning the domain conversion. Until now, the interpreter was just able to convert from time to depth. Now, we allow the interpreters converting from time to depth as well as from depth to time, volumes, models, horizons, and newly faults. Of course, this domain conversion is optimum if you use the interactive velocity modeling of Paloscan because you can interactively switch between time and depth domain or depth and time domain depending on the input domain. You can still integrate the wave velocity data if needed to constrain this real-time velocity modeling towards this real-time domain conversion. And of course, at any time, the interpreter is still able to switch between the preview of the velocity modeling, still performed in real time, even if you can realize such cubes, and the input sequence object that has been improved as well by the integration of new lithological pattern, as you can see, for instance, concerning the yellow seismic unit that has been filled with a homoki cross-stratification pattern. A new improvement concerning the horizons covers the creation of structural maps. So now you can use your fault polygons coming from the water type model. So the fault polygons are created based on the intersection between the water type horizons and the water type faults. And so those fault polygons can be used to create structural maps directly onto your horizons. Another improvement concerns the attribute mapping and in particular the window we use to map attributes. So until now, if we consider a basic attribute such as the root mean square amplitude, until now we were able to exclusively generate this attribute according to a centered window. So the window was directly centered to the voxel intersected by the map. And we have decided to integrate two other methods, one concerning a below window. That means, for instance, if you want to snap the root mean square information of a reservoir that is overlapped by a horizon, you can do this thanks to the below window, and you can do the same process with a window based on the analysis of the voxels exclusively above your horizon of interest. New improvements concerning the measure tool. So starting from the analysis of the map and, for instance, the topography, we can, of course, still switch between the z-value and attributes in order to compare the topography and, for instance, the anomalies of amplitudes. And so based on those anomalies of amplitudes, we can still change the color scale and we can draw a measure tool that is drastically different from the previous one because it is composed of a multitude of segments. So the behavior is extremely similar to an open polyline or the creation of an arbitrary line. And the interesting feature of this new measure tool composed of several segments is that each segment collects the distance between each apex of this measurement tool. Other improvements concerning the contouring. So here we still have the topography. So until now, the contouring was composed of the isolines themselves and the value, the ISO values, but the step management was not allowed. Now you can control the step concerning the ISO values. So you can really control the nature and the details of the maps you want to display. And of course, this new management is still implemented and can be correlated with the management of the isoline step and limits. The horizon properties have been improved by the collection of X, Y, Z ranges in order to always be able to QC the geographic and topographic features of your maps. Very useful in order to compare the survey coordinates coming from the cube and the coordinates coming from the horizons, so as a QC tool. And one of the last main improvements concerning the horizons concerns the GRV, the gross rock volume tool, that has been improved because, for instance, here we are considering an anticline, and instead of just defining a polygon based on to a constant ISO value, now we can control the cutoff of not only the minimum depth or the maximum depth of your topographic map, but you can control both of them thanks to the color bar. That means, for instance, we can eliminate the hinge zone of the anticline if it has no interest in terms of prospection. And thanks to the step of the gross rock volumetrics calculation, we can of course correlate the reference ISO value along the limbs and according to the contouring we have previously parameterized. So I finish with a slide and I let Jean-Philippe carrying on with the live demo. Thank you.
Thanks, Nicolas, for this presentation. I will just start the last live demo, and then Nicolas will finish with a PowerPoint presentation. Just share my application. Okay, during this presentation, I will use North Sea volume, the FO3 volume, and I will carry from volume import up to the GRV computation in depth domain. Okay, first of all, when you import a seismic, sometimes due to high value or very low value in the border, and you open your seismic, sometimes you can have something like this. And even if you try to change and manage the color bar, it was not possible to display the seismic due to this very high or low value. Due to this, we have implemented a new tool for the data conditioning. If you just right click, it's the dispack option. PaleoScan will compute for my volume the min and max of this volume. And then I can just remove value higher or lower than a value, an amplitude, okay? For example, this is the minimum and maximum of my volume. And if I want, I can customize just to remove value and just keep value between this range of value. And then PaleoScan will create a new volume. And like this, okay, in this case, if I remove this kind of value very high, I will have this kind of result. And now I can display my seismic, I can play with the color bar. And okay, for example, if you prefer this kind of color bar, okay, the data will be displayed correctly. Then, okay, when you have import and data condition your seismic, you can carry on the PaleoScan workflow to create your model grid, your interpretation. And then when you have your interpretation, we can create, as I explained during one of the presentation about the relative geological time model, different kind of model. And for example, for this time, time volume, I create two different kind of models. The first one was a Marconi model, okay, very synthetic, but full without any gaps and very clean. And one, a classic relative geological time model, more seismic consistent, okay, but I have gaps due to salt dome or due to bad signal to noise ratio, this kind of thing, but much more seismic consistent. Okay. And if I want, I can use these two different relative geological time models to do different kind of things. In this case, I want to depth convert my volume. Okay, I can just activate my sequence. And then, for example, I can create a sequence stratigraphy. Thanks. Oh, sorry. Oh, not this one. Thanks to the Marconi model, to have very synthetic model. Okay, if I just activate, you see I have horizons isoline complete through the full volume, and like this I can create synthetic layer. And for each layer, thanks to the velocity modeling, I can choose one velocity. We still have the same option for the velocity computation as the previous release of PaleoScan: constant, linear, linear from the top, from bottom, or from well log. And like this, PaleoScan will create a velocity model. Okay, you can preview this model, and we can use this model to, in real time, depth convert my seismic. Okay, and I just click on T shortcut just to switch from time to depth. First new feature of PaleoScan 2020. Now it's possible, okay, on the 2019 it was possible from time to depth as this one, but now it's also possible from depth to time. If you have your velocity model, PaleoScan can time convert your depth volume. Second new feature of this domain conversion, now it's also possible to depth convert some faults. Okay, if I just drag and drop my fault set, PaleoScan, okay, I will just display the fault, and PaleoScan will depth convert, and like this I can save not only my volume, my model, and my horizons as the previous release of PaleoScan in the other domain, in this case in depth domain, but now I can also depth convert or time convert the faults thanks to this tool. Okay, and I can display, I can switch exactly as previous in real time between time or depth domain directly. And like this, thanks, okay, just a few seconds just to come back in time domain. Thanks to this tool, okay, I create different outputs. The first one, it's now I have my volume in depth domain. Also, I convert the relative geological time model, the classic, who are more seismic consistent, also in depth domain to create my horizon stack or to do some sequence stratigraphy. And I also depth convert all the faults. And due to this, I can use all this input for different kind of things. The first one, if I want, oh, sorry, horizon stack, I can create an horizon stack. Okay, I use my model in depth. Okay, I want to display my seismic in depth. I can choose the number of horizons. Like this, I will create horizon stack in depth domain. And then I can choose to map a different kind of attributes, for example, RNS amplitude. And as Nicola explained during his presentation, now we have more options for the extraction of attributes. For example, the Windows extraction. Now it's possible to use different kind of windows above the horizons, center, or below the horizons. Okay, and like this, you will obtain directly your horizon stack with RMS amplitude. Also, if you want, you can create a sequence with the depth model and the depth seismic like this, because I use the classic relative geological time model more seismic consistent, I can create my model much more in detail, much more geologically consistent. Of course, I've got, it really depends the kind of work you have to do. And then, okay, just one point concerning the new feature of PaleoScan 2020. If I select my layer under the property, okay, you still have access to the background, and to the lithologic pattern. And we have implemented much more geological lithologic pattern. Okay, you can still change the color like this. And like this, you can really customize. You can still, of course, display the stratocolumn, and we update the stratocolumn with the new lithologic pattern directly. Okay, now I have my sequence. Also, if I just drag and drop, I have my fault in depth domain. Okay, as you can see, PaleoScan don't convert all my faults because the fault was picked in bigger volume than this one, and because I don't have intersection, it don't convert all the fault bigger than volume. But in normal workflow, you will have very good result for the depth conversion. And like this, okay, I have my fault, my model, and my sequence in depth domain, and I can use to create. I will just close my water type model. I will just open my seismic in depth. Okay, I will just remove, toggle off my fault. And if I want, under water type model, I can create my water type model directly in depth domain, thanks to my sequence stratigraphy. And if I want, thanks to this water type model, I can extract, okay, of course, some horizons, or I can extract from my horizon stack in depth I presented you just before. And if I want, I can extract some fault polygon, for example. Okay, I have extract the fault polygon for the BCU horizons. And if I just go on the polyline, okay, I will just drag and drop. And if I display my 3D viewer, increase the size, I will have, okay, automatically I have my fault polygon extract into the depth domain. Okay, I have also extract the horizon from the BCU from my horizon stack. And like this. Okay, I have my horizon in depth domain with my fault polygon directly create in depth domain. And then I can do different kind of thing. Okay, I will just remove all my object in 3D. I will just open my horizon. First of all, as Nicolas explained, we have now a different, a better measurement tool and new tool for horizons management. For the measurement tool, now it's by segment. Okay, for example, okay, I can follow one fault like this, and if I want, I can really change, okay, the distance. Sorry, I click once more at the bottom at the end, but like this, you can really, okay, measure many different kind of distance. Okay, it's better measurement tool. Also, if I want, I can use the fault polygon I use for the extraction to have structural map. For example, okay, from my horizons, okay, extract. And then, okay, I just have to choose my fault polygon. I will just zoom in on this part. And I can use this fault polygon, okay, to choose if I want to keep the horizon inside or outside the fault polygon. In this case, I want to keep outside. And like this, PaleoScan will remove my fault polygon through my horizons to create some structural map. And like this, we will obtain this kind of result, okay, with all the gap. Okay, now I have managed, okay, I can measure some distance. I have my horizon in depth. I can create my water type model in depth, my fault polygon, sorry, in depth, and I can do my structural map. Now, if I want, I can play with these horizons. And for example, I want to compute some GRV. On the previous release of PaleoScan, it was only possible to, okay, to use with mean or max value. Okay, I have only one value as threshold for the color selection. Now we have a new interval value selection. And like this, for example, for anticline, you can really customize depending the area you need to compute for the GRV. If you want, you can directly compute your threshold value. And if you want to have more control and more display, you can play with the contouring. As Nicolas explained, we have much more control and much more option for the contouring. For example, okay, I just, yeah, sorry, step. step 50, for example, I can change precision to have much more control. And like this, I can play with this parameter, okay, to have more control and check what's happened for before to start the GRV computation. And then I just have to go under horizons. I just have to select like this the area I need for the GRV computation. And PaleoScan, okay, will ask me the step and will compute the GRV. As you can see on the top right corner, okay, the conversion, it's not available because we work directly in depth domain, because we do all the workflow to work in depth domain, and depth convert this seismic. And like this, you can compute your GRV directly in depth domain thanks to this workflow and thanks to all this tool we implement for the 2020 release.